December 25th, Christmas. This is it. The power has just turned off for maintenance or something. I've decided to take care of that, Sharon, and I could set things straight for Daddy. Praise be to Cayne. Yeah, four times. Interesting. Check out the safe last. The damaged radio blares a static tune.
Oh my god. I know him. I know this guy.
What guy?
There's a photo of... Oh shit.
Is that the doc?
Old boyfriend?
Drunken bar night in a morning full of regrets.
Really?
They paid for the procedure. They chose the hospital.
Who?
Cayne Corporation.
Cayne is a third party? So she knew. She was the young girl. In the PDA. A photograph sign, Love Joseph. It also furnishes a lipstick kiss and a suspect stain in the corner. She's the one mentioned here. Adams paid him earlier this year to screw a young girl. That's us. That's Hadley. And here we are. Paid her to do it. Alright. So we know who the father is. So Adams wanted it, so this is... We're part of Adams' experiment of some kind.
Maybe if I... Wait, no. Oh, for shit's sake!
I don't know, I don't want to combine that with anything.
Stupid Hadley.
Maybe if I jam it in. On second thought, I'm getting desperate.
I wonder if I still wonder if he can read our data record.
Stupid, stupid Hadley. Hadley, what would your mother say? I think not.
This is why I do it, guys. What do we make? Makeshift lever. The stripper pole and blade have been combined to create an improvised lever.
How fudgesicles. It's gonna work. If I turn it around, it may fit. Probably not.
I suppose I can get into this terminal. I want to read these records. Watch, I'll probably read them at the very end or something. I've been running for quite a while, I guess we'll keep going. Are they going to use that to get that body? So whose blood is this? Is this all Julia's blood and who else? Can I use the picture to get through anything? This is Adams. It's not going to work here, but... Let's try it anyway, I don't know.
Hmm.
So how do I get past this?
On second thought, nope.
How do I get up here? I can't yet.
Maybe if I... Wait. Nope.
Alright, let's go back to the other room.
I love Juca-Cola. Love it.
They say it's made from people.
So like green?
Juca-Cola is made of love and happiness.
I don't think this will do anything, but...
Oh, fudgesicles! Ain't gonna work. If I turn it around, it may fit. Probably not.
Yeah, let's go back to the nasty body stuff. Now this is some kind of brain thing in here. Hopefully we can get the code again there. Alright, let's see if I can get this body. I don't think we want an imprint. Broken lever mechanism. The lever seems to have been violently snapped off at the base and disposed of. Oh, so it is two levers. I didn't even notice this one. So we can put this lever in here then. That works. So to move this even more? Maybe we can use the hydraulic mechanism to take that out. The makeshift lever fits snugly in the fixed support. Okay, pull lever.
Holy Toledo.
What are we gonna do?
It's the worst that could happen.
Ooh!
I'll be darned. Like cracking open a lobster. I think I'm gonna hurl.
A body.
Never did like seafood.
A body came out of it.
I think I'll be giving it a skip going forward.
Oh, it's a womb, so it gave birth to something. Oh, it made this go up, though. So we can get to the corpse.
I can do this.
Ooh! She scared so loud. It scared me. Oh! Dead? What the hell? It took us somewhere? Where are we in this? Oh, jeez. Ooh. I wonder if I should have used the whip. So wait, those things pulled us in, but we swam away?
That was nasty.
How do we get out of here? Where are we? Is this on the other... Oh, stasis pods? Really? Is this on the other side of the... the grub habitat and stuff? kneeling stone idol, a moldering monument to humanity's many sins. Okay, so I guess this is Dr. Kern's work here. Pale, delicate threads of lichen cling to its hands and knees like some torpid corruption of the flesh. Stasis pod. The chef d'oeuvre. Hors d'oeuvres. The chef d'oeuvre, I guess? I don't know. Of this perverse tableau, a limp body slouches between the cables and circuitry of its life support apparatus. I guess this is Hendry Caine. Grasping hands. The crumbling fingers seem almost to hesitate, perhaps with pious wonder, above the stasis pod. Well, who builds this stuff, or brings it here, or whatever? Shrine room. A dark silence hangs in the air. Someone's had a little too much time on their hands. Baptism pool. An engraved inscription reads, "These waters shall wash away your depravities, your lies, and your hubris." The water is brackish, as though it were penitent tears tumbled from the solemn supplicant above it. All these candles.
Speak of the devil.
What do you see?
Cayne.
I think this is Hendry Caine.
Hendry is dead.
Why is she bending at the knee?
Well, hallelujah then, he's here.
Alive?
In stasis.
Ooh.
Yes, yes. I know you're in there, trust me. I know. You don't have to remind me. I can feel you, all right?
Okay. Iron candelabras. The flames wither and wane in the stale air. Darkness. Nothing but an echo and stagnation looms from the darkness. Cayne is kept safe in this custodian's cradle. Cryo control panel. This terminal controls and regulates the stasis pod. Kneeling children. Even the innocent must grovel in this obscene beatitude. Prostrate human effigies. Rapturous faces gaze into the night, praying for grace and absolution that will never come. Hendry. What if that was Hendry? Sallow skin bulges around 1,000 gossamer scars, the surgical seams of this patchwork messiah. So if I'm right then, this is the founder of Cayne, the original. From 20,000 or something like that? But he lived to be very old. I guess it still wasn't forever. Look, there's a foot there. Why did she need... I guess she was feeling the baby? It looks like she was kneeling in supplication to him. Alright, so we're going to work the cryo control panel for some reason. I can't even leave here. So what happened to those things that tried to grab us? Oh, I got a cryo unit.
Oh, relax. It'll take months for you to thaw out.
Can I leave? Okay. Oh, it's opened. Yeah, now we're supposed to get the death penalty or something. She won't run. Okay, this is where I thought we were. Okay. Alright, so I have a blank PDT, A broken PDT. The PDT is streaked with blood and smashed beyond repair, but the data storage might still work. And I have a cryo unit. A heavy-duty cryo unit for the regulation of cryostasis.
On second thought, nope.
I know, I was supposed to use that for the, thing.
Hadley needs to get her head checked.
Huh. Is that in here? I forget. I think so. No. No, it's not in here. The entire body's gone. That was pretty nasty. Still wonder what we're gonna need Joseph Brano's voice for. Good thing there's no one around to give us the death penalty. Kinda wonder if we're gonna run into any of those crew facilities. Do I want? No. I want PDT printer room. Kinda wonder if we're gonna run into any turrets or robots that will open fire on us. Cause those could still give us the death penalty. Hi, friend.
Let's print a PDT together. Hi, friend. I'm Ralph. Let's print a PDT together.
Okay, you weird freaking thing.
Blank PDT accepted.
That fits nicely.
Okay. Can we use the broken one as a template?
Template PDT accepted.
Awesome. Glad I don't have to touch that again.
This is exciting. I'm trying so long to make one of these friggin' PDTs. Cryo unit.
Cryo regulator accepted.
Defrosted.
Why does she look like that? Well, there's someone in there. I thought that was her reflection. What the? Who the hell is in there? John Kern.
Oh, wonderful. Your PDT has been printed. Oopsie. An incorrect cryo-regulator.
Please kill me, thanks.
Used. An overload is imminent. Goodbye.
Overload? Ooh! Oh my.
Okay. The security system is reset. The elevator should be open, and I have a PDT.
Excellent.
Yes.
I can hear the alert. You must be close.
Twisted remains. Well, that means she's going to be after us, the Samantha, right? That's her? The glass tube is erupted. Fatty lumps of flesh and brain tissue sputtering wetly in the flames. The explosion has turned this vat almost inside out, its contents violently ejected all over the floor. Curdled preservation fluid drips from the crumpled aluminum veneer. Nothing but splinters, ash, and smoldering clumps of blackened debris at the desk. We probably should leave this room. The projection flickers erratically, its program glitching out from the power surge. Still trying to read everything. Scalded scorched terminal. A useless molten mass of whirling silicon and polycarb casing. Blood and putrid organic matter have liquefied and burned into the heated plastic, congealing into scalded blisters of emulsified core. Now, this is great stuff. This is the same PDT, isn't it? Yeah. Toxic fumes smother the air as the fire starts to purge this place of its crimes. It's getting like... Is it burning out or something? This PDT is now fully operational.
Grasping at straws, Hadley. Probably not a good idea. Hadley, are you on drugs?
Mm-hmm. Are we gonna get attacked now? Probably should save. Because the gate is down.
No, I can't.
What's wrong?
The barrier is torn to pieces.
Be vigilant, Hadley. I'm counting on you.
Do this. Be brave. You can do this. You're doing it.
Had a feeling that we're going to be chased in here and we're going to want to do this. To replicate what happened with him and destroy that thing. But now that we have the PDT, we can work this atmosphere thing. And that's what I remember, that we really wanted to... We couldn't operate that without it. Still reminds me of a sphincter. The atmosphere control. So that the grubs will release the pheromones or whatever it is that they do again. Active PDT required. Alright, well... I guess if I go like this... Air filtration normal, mode fan, heater auto, irrigation pump auto. Do we need a different humidity? Oh, for what area? You're kidding. I need to go back and find the area? Is there something stenciled there? Tell us what area is what.
The last thing I said to my son was to get out there and carve his own name into the world and stop relying on mine.
Charles Cayne?
Did you mean it? Sometimes kids know that their parents say things they don't mean. My mom? The last thing she said to me was that I was the reason she was alone. That I sapped the life out of her from the moment I came into existence.
You know that's not true.
A small part of me knows that. A bigger part doesn't.
I know this doesn't pause, but I have to take a break. Okay, let's get back down. I don't know what area that is. Oh, when something's gonna come after us through that fence. Getting really nervous. My guess is we don't try to go through there yet. We want to calm her down with this gas. Wait, is this what we want? Crew? No.
Tunes from my own personal collection.
That voice.
Relax and let the gross of taking you to a better place.
Now we recognize Joseph's voice, huh? I realize we went through there. The blaze has engulfed the lift. I was hoping we might be able to get to more areas. I don't know how we get up there. This isn't where we want to be. We want to be... Run. The birthing labs.
I'm gonna light pants on fire to show sensual energy. Oh.
I'm worried every time we go into this area we're gonna see something. Something gonna be going on in here? So we want to adjust the temperature in here specifically.
So they use these little guys to control Samantha.
Mm-hmm.
The gas they give off when they touch dead tissue calms her. I need to catch one.
Hint, hint. So we also need, I guess they felt like they wanted to give us a clue there. We need a platform. Not a platform, a container. It tells us when we try to...
Notice baited canister require full drop extraction.
Baited canister. Where would we find a baited canister? See anything here about area? Grub habitat. This we're gonna do Boland. Oh wait, we got the humidity here. Okay. Alright. So humidity 84 RH. But what area is this? Any clues here? Atmospheric and environmental control. So we have this here, but doesn't seem like you can control anything here. Is this anything here? I don't know if this is a number. 2? 3? Maybe a PDT mentions it? A PDA. PDA mentions it, not a PDT. He really doesn't talk about the grubs. No. It's in the PDT printing area. Sharon talks about it. Anything else is going on in here? There's no air, it looks like numbers over this. Every time I come out in here, I'm looking for this figure. He's gonna be coming after us. Oh, the brain emulation lab is open. I'm really not happy that that's open. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode when we check out the brain emulation lab and then try to maybe the PDD printer room. We need to, I wish we had numbers over these doors or something. We need to figure out where to change the humidity and temperature. Unless I just force do it for everything. Which would be stupid. But thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next episode, and always seek adventure.